Hi, welcome to the first part of my video on my Crimson Guitars build. And after a 2.5 hour drive, I've been given a warm welcome here, and we've already picked some woods for my guitar. So here's a nice bit of sapuli for the back, and then the neck is going to be cut out of this blank, which is a bit of nice flamed maple that they'll make two necks out of, so we'll take the better half of that. Then I'm going to, we found a good bit of purple heart that will go down the middle of the body as a, I call it a skunk stripe, and hopefully that will look nice. And then we're going to try and cut the wings out of this rather splendid bit of maple, which has got some very nice flame across here and an interesting bit of figuring down there. So hopefully we'll be able to make a nice body out of these, something like that. We shall see. I've got Christopher looking approvingly at me off camera, at least for the time being. And the last bit is the fretboard, and we found a very nice bit of ebony with a really interesting pattern on it for the fretboard. So there we go, that's the first elements. And next, I think, will be chopping them into small pieces and trying not to chop my fingers into small pieces.
Is that all comparable to you for this guitar? Depth of body.
Yeah,
cool.
We need to work out where the controls are going to go, I guess, as well as that before we decide on the body shape, maybe.
True, that would be helpful. So traditionally, there McCartney has the top up there, and then sort of the traditional.
And then if we make it thicker, I could make a sort of big smiley. With volume, three-way selector, tone, five-way selector, a little bit then there. But I think I should
have it.
That looks pretty good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I know one of Ben's precepts is that the guitars we build here have to be aesthetically pleasing.
Yes.
So we have to do that above all.
It's just thrown away. So, what I'm going to go do is pencil off that rough edge.
Yeah.
We can plane that down so we'll have a better idea of where things are.
Mm-hmm.
I can plane that top surface and we can lay out the depths of our cuts. And then I can start setting up the bandsaw to do that.
Yeah.
While I'm doing that, I'll set you up and have you joint one of these edges 90 degrees for the planer, and then we'll measure out our 65 mil, keep the line down, bandsaw close, plane it to shape. And
do you think 65 is okay in terms of keeping enough of this to have...
Yeah.
To prevent this from being too close to the cut here.
Yeah.
So I guess either we make this narrow or we just cut a little bit more of this off.
Yes.
Maybe just cutting a little bit more of this off is the better idea, isn't it?
Yeah, it's this one.
Or keep this in sort of a image.
Yeah.
Move it along.
Yeah, what I'm looking for right now is just roughly where that it's giving us plenty of extra over to work with. Just I want to see if there's any sort of occlusions or anything, how deep those go, which I think I may go to about there. Shouldn't you? Plenty of space.
So I haven't shown all of the steps in the machine room because I didn't want to take the video camera in there. But what we've got is I've got my neck, which has been marked out, and I bandsawed off the top of the headstock. Next step is to plane that down. The body has been cut down to size and marked out. And I've got my purple heart stripe here and the fretboard. And Christopher has just cut out the other bits for the top and bandsawed them. And that looks rather magnificent, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So we have something like this, which I can't see in the camera at the moment, will be the body of the guitar. I think that's nearly there.
Alright, so it looks like this, we've got a slight low spot on this side now.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Cool.
Just getting everything lined up and making sure I put in the right sides in the right way.
I thought one would have put some glue in there at this stage. Yeah. So,
no? I stared long and hard, and eventually it shamed itself into a joint.
Alright, we're just going to take a small pass on each one of these maple pieces.
Mm-hmm.
With a long set plane, probably number 7, just to clean that edge up. We just really want to look for one smooth shading. As soon as we get that, we're done. And that should just tighten that joint up just a tiny bit.
Mm-hmm.
And provide a more stable surface. Noticeably.
Yep.
Yeah. Alright, so. Alright.
It would be almost unique as actually producing production guitars in England as opposed to. Quite a few luthiers doing custom stuff, but not much in the production.
Yeah, most companies just end up outsourcing, which is a shame, but it's understandable. It's the costs involved are kind of high, but if you can find a model that works.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So this guy, we need to get a truss rod in.
The center line as an extension of this one along there, so I can line it up with it.
Okay. Sorry, I've got 6.5 right now. Between 6.5 and 7, where we take the measurement from. Do you have a particular preference for which side to use?
I think this side and with the headstock being this end. Glue on the bit that you like.
Exactly. Yeah, should be alright.
Approval or disapproval?
Yep, I'm good with that.
Right. So, same thing on the other end, just to try and square it off?
Yes.
This is okay here.
I like that. Okay. Excellent. All right.
Let's have a look at the secret area under the bench. That's where the body has been drying, and we'll get that out in a minute.
Next, it's one of those things you really gotta have clamps for.
Yeah. Do you need more than that, or is it about?
Should be right.
Right now. So by the end of today, we have a body, maybe not quite cut, but.
Uh-huh.
And we have a neck with fretboard and fret slots.
Yes.
I wonder what we'll do for 5 more days.
Pretty much done.
Yeah. Just needs to be screwed together and
off you. Alright, so we just get some clamps going on.
So we
start one either end.
Leave that till tomorrow now.
Yeah.
Cool.
Right.
That's good.
Very good. Thank you.
lines it is. We've got several lines on there now.
Only one of them is blue.
Okay, good. So that's probably the last thing for today then.
Yes.
Then sort out the body. So we've got body, we've got top, which fits perfectly on top, more or less. And the neck with the glue drying over there.